It's the trooper. Saturday night, Las Vegas. Of course, where else would we be, right? Questions need to be answered. One, where am I going to play poker tonight? And two, what am I going to eat? Not necessarily in that order, though.
Thanks for the hat.
Oh, yeah. Mark and Aaron.
Yeah, thank
from
you.
From Idaho.
Yeah, from Idaho. North Idaho.
From North Idaho. North
not
Idaho.
Potato Idaho.
Yeah.
Right.
North Idaho is almost like a different state than
really?
Southern Idaho.
Oh, okay.
Southern Idaho is like an entirely different environment.
I like
and North Idaho is like lakes and mountains and rivers.
Express is extremely awful. Now we know. It definitely ain't no Panda Express. But I was moments away from tears. I was so hungry, so I did what I could do. Well, the decision of where to eat was a bad one. Let's hope the decision of where to play poker goes the other way. Chow mein, quote unquote, tastes like watery spaghetti with some kind of weird garlic flavor on it. Just awful.
Michigan.
Shout out to Mallory over there too. Thanks a lot. You know what I found to kill the taste of shitty food court Chinese food? Lemon sparkly pop. Maybe it's just me, but it seems awfully quiet in here. Shout out to John Michael from Utah, who is in there playing that Daily Deep Stack tournament at the moment. 4 p.m. Daily Deep Stack, only 86 entries. I mean, I don't remember what the numbers were in 2019, but I can tell you that it wasn't 86, it was hundreds of players in those daily deep stack tournaments. I imagine the vaccine shit and the mask shit and all this COVID shit has a lot to do with it. Sad. I honestly don't know if the company who owns Caesars, I don't even know what it's called anymore. Is it Caesars Entertainment anymore, or is it El Dorado whatever? I honestly don't know if they give a damn about the World Series of Poker. I know that during normal times, the World Series just has to be a massive value to the company. If for no other reason than just to bring tens of thousands of people to Vegas during the summer. Of course, it's not summer now, but you get the point. Now, about that other decision that needs to be made, where to play poker. I bit my tongue and it really hurts. So fortunately, we're done with the talking portion of the vlog for the moment. Saturday night comes to a close with a sparkly pop. Grape. The sounds of Vegas. People screaming on the street. What? So friendly table at Resorts World tonight. I end up winning 208. That's in for 300, out for 508. Someone's yelling. Kind of an interesting hand. The game was very, very tame when I sat down. Not a lot of pots going on, not a lot of anything happening for, you know, first half hour or so at the table, when suddenly I find myself on the button with aces, under the gun limped in, hijack raises to 15, and because there's really not a lot going on, I just decide to call 15 with my aces on the button. And the under-the-gun limper calls the 15. The three of us see the flop. The flop was jack, tray, deuce, rainbow. And the guy who had limped under the gun led for 25. The preflop raiser and the hijack folded. And when it came over to me once again, this is a pretty calm board. So I just call 25. The turn card is the seven of spades, and the guy leads for 25 again. So I raise it just 40 more, you know what I mean? So he calls the 40 more. The river card is a three of spades. So we have jack, tray, deuce, one spade, seven of spades on the turn, three of spades on the river. It did put three spades in the back door, but nobody's worried about that.
He actually led for 25 again. So I go all in for 145, and he calls with ace-jack. So, worked out for me. There was another funny little hand where I had pocket threes. You know, I just called them trays, right? And now I'm calling them threes. Trooper, which is it? I mean, there are no twos in a deck of playing cards. There are only deuces. There are no twos. You do not have pocket twos. You do not flop a two. You do not river a two. There are no twos. Threes? I'm a little more lenient with threes personally, but they really should be referred to as trays. So, I have pocket trays in the big blind. The cutoff, shout out to the cutoff, I didn't get your name, raised to 15. The button called 15, and I called 15 from the big blind. Three-way flop. Tray, tray, deuce. So I had it in my head that 15 minutes earlier, I played the aces the way that I did. I had it in my, and believe me, cutoff, who just raised this pot, I know that he's paying attention. He's paying close attention to everything going on the table. Good for him. He's paying attention, and I know it. I've already made up my mind that if I flop a set of trays, I am going to lead the flop. But when quads smack you in the face right on the flop, sometimes you lose you get a little distracted by that. It's like, okay, what a flop for pocket trays. Tray, tray, deuce. I checked. In hindsight, I believe checking is the wrong damn play here. Especially given, well, we can't look at the hindsight of the way the button was behaving throughout the hand. I check, cutoff checked, who was the preflop raiser. The button let out for 15. I just call 15. And the cutoff folds. And I hate the way I played this hand because I played it the exact same way that I just played aces. So the turn card is a 5. And so now we have tray, tray, deuce, 5. I check again, and the button bets 50, and I just call 50. This is where it just looks too obvious. You know what I mean? It looks like I have a tray in my hand. I'm kind of feeling like the button has a pocket pair, maybe pocket sevens, eights, who knows? Well, here's another damn good reason not to check call the turn on a tray, tray, deuce, 5. Because the 4 peels off. What a stupid card to just destroy any action that I could have dreamt of having. That's right, dreamt, not dreamed. So, I had $432, and I just was thinking about it. I'm like, yo, I mean, the dude's folding. He's not gonna call anything. But if he's going to call anything, maybe he'll call 130. So I push 130 over the line, and he pretty quickly folds. I mean, he's not folding to my bet. He's folding to the board. You know what I mean? If the river isn't some ridiculous card like a 4, giving a straight to an ace or a 6 or whatever, and I check, he is probably just going to check behind. Feels really nice out here. I'm going to go ahead and guess the temperature. I'm gonna guess the temperature is 61 degrees. Pretty damn good guess. Pretty damn good guess. Of course, you saw me look at it. That's why it's a joke and not a lie. Remember, if you like my videos, please do click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends about the videos and leave a comment down below. The sounds of Vegas. Crazy hookers on the street. No, I don't even know what I'm talking about. I'll see you next time.